Hey, hi, hello, good afternoon. Namaskara, Bengaluru. I am Archana from Work TV and you are watching my show Voice. Gender equality. What is that one thing strikes your mind when you hear this word? Yes, it's equality between men and women, and women getting all her rights and opportunities like men to showcase herself. From cooking to cleaning, from taking care of children or elder one, women carry out 3 times more household and care work than men. By denying women rights, we deny half of the life to lead up to the fullest. We have heard lot many cases when it matters to women, but what about men? Do you believe even men go through lots of outrage and intimidation by women? Yes, male victims can be helped through proper intervention and recognition of violence against men by women as a public issue. Here I have someone even-handed who has been fighting for such victim. How many of us would get down to look up to her? Here I have the unbiased Miss Priya Arya, founder of Smile of Zindagi, social activist, and also a motivational speaker. The very compassionate soul who picks up the one who is depressed, who motivates the one who is trying to give up, and who consoles the one who is grieving. A very happy, warm, and welcome to my show, ma'am. And I'm waiting what you're going to tell me today and what are the things you have to voice out for us.
Thank you, Archana. It was a very, very, very nice introduction. Thank you so much. gender equality. When we speak about gender equality, we forget the third gender community.
Yes.
We don't even consider it a gender, I think. It is just between men and women. And the minute we speak about equality, it becomes only about women. So there are laws, there is everything about, uplifting women. But there are these two genders which are left behind completely. So how are we even talking about equality when we don't have anything to support the two other genders, which are majority? So that is where I come in, where we fight for rights in terms of, not in terms of just gender. We don't look at people just as gender. We look at people, we look at humans as humans, irrespective of the gender. And the entire focus is on how to bring down the competition that has now begun between both the genders, the toxic feminism that has creeped in. So patriarchy and toxic feminism, they're like two extreme ends. So we have to now merge it in and learn how to peacefully coexist, because all genders have a very major role to play in our mental health, in our uplifting of the generation next, in everything. So naturally, we were born the way we are, born without competition. What men can do, women can't, and what women can do, men can't. So
exactly.
And when we talk about equality, we are so biased about so many things. I am a woman, I can do everything. If I pick up the phone, I can get through anywhere, anyhow. It is easy for me to even work in the office. It is easy for me to get appointments. The trust is more on me vis-a-vis on men. Men struggle a lot more than us. A lot more. And they play less victim cards than we do. So how are we being equal here? I expect a man to open the door for me. Why? I expect a man to stand up when I come. Why? Why should anybody stand up for me? So there is this glorified feminism. We need chauvinists also. We need the chauvinism in the men. Why you want to, we call them chauvinist pigs also. On the other hand, there are victims or in female category also who have been, we have seen gory victims in terms of rapes, in terms of domestic violence. So we stand by them too, because then they are not empowered enough to stand up and speak about their problems. So we empower everybody irrespective of the gender, and that is what equality stands for. So if I want my man to open the door for me, it's okay for me to open the door for him too. If I want my man to take care of me, it's okay for me to take care of him too. If I want my man to pay my bills, it's okay for me to cook for him.
Very, very beautifully said, ma'am. Very beautifully said. And tell me, ma'am, how did you start these courses? Like, what is about Simplify, Smilify Zindagi? And what made you work on this, you know, gender equality? How did this thought process run into your mind?
Smilify started as a training center. And I'm a counselor also by profession. I'm a therapist. So I practice CBT. So as a therapist, we come across a lot of, and I am more into marriage counseling. So very proudly, I say I have saved 305 marriages to date. So
we are glad to know that, ma'am. We are glad. It's a pleasure. We are knowing that. Yeah.
But at the same time, what I noticed throughout my marriage counseling was the victim card played by one or the other gender.
Yes.
Small issues becoming big because of the notions that how a gender should behave.
Yes.
I am not saying one particular gender, I am talking about both the genders. Now, problem is the gender roles have got mixed in this generation. Till back then, one person working in the office will not run the house. Both of them have to work. So the gender roles have got mixed. Now with the gender roles mixing, the confusion has erupted. That, okay, if I'm going to the office, I want you also to cook for me. It's as simple as that. So, and men and women, both, they have seen their parents in a certain light. They expect their parents' replica in their spouses. That is not possible in today's life. Because roles are merging. The families are becoming nuclear families. So we cannot expect that. The expectations are high. And the gender equations are different. The gender definitions are getting different now. And on top of that, the competition has come in. Who's better, female or male? So all of that, the experience that I went through during my counseling sessions, put all these thoughts in me, obviously. And when you listen to the news, when you listen to everything, and you see the fake feminism that is coming, you see the fake feminism. Being a feminist is different. I am a pure feminist. Being a feminist is different. If you're a feminist, you empower women to stand up for the cause. You do not say men are worst, men are this, men are that, patriarchy.
We can't keep blaming. Yeah.
No. You will teach them how to empower themselves while coexisting peacefully in the environment that they are in. You'll teach them how to communicate, how to put across their thought without hurting egos. Being a feminist doesn't mean you stand up and you start smoking and drinking and taking drugs and going around sleeping around or just cussing. The cuss words used by the so-called feminists are quite alarming. So no, you do not do all that because you have to feel empowered. Empowered means how you can, no matter what situation is thrown at you, how you can solve that without playing the victim card. The mindset should be of solving, the problem solving ability, the communication skills, the inner peace. Why maintaining the outer peace? So the mental health, basically, overall mental health. So that is what empowerment is. So that is where this thought came, and that is how, and I stand very strongly against fake news. So whenever I see any of the laws being misused, because we come across so many cases where, have you seen the suicide rates in men? Just pick up the census and see the suicide rates, the percentage of men versus women, over 60%. Almost close to 70% suicides are male suicides.
Okay.
And out of them, a large number is because of domestic violence on them.
Okay.
How many? Okay, I'll give you two examples. A man standing with a stick next to a woman beating her up. What will be your reaction? And a woman standing with a bale and beating up a man, what will be your reaction? The bias in his hands. A woman
yes.
with a very, so cute, ha 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 ha.
Yes.
But he's not a human being, or what? Mard ko dard nahi hota, kya hota hai?
Nahi, bilkul hota hai.
We need to just, you know, we have been filled with crap.
Hmm.
So crap, and we need to erase all of that if we really want a peaceful coexistence going ahead. मर्द को दर्द भी होता है, मर्द रोता भी है. मर्द को नेचर ने वही इमोशंस दिए हैं जो औरत को दिए.
True.
बट मर्द को सिखाया गया है इमोशंस आर बैड, यू हैव टू बी द मैचो मैन. उसी में मर जाता है बेचारा, चाहे उसके पास रेप हो, चाहे डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस हो, चाहे फॉल्स केस हो, वो जाके किसी के सामने मुंह नहीं खोलता. A better position to stand up and talk. The laws are with us. Show me one law which is for men.
There's no laws for men, I believe. Yeah. I believe, ma'am, like if there is a...
Actually triggered everything in me much more than anything else. Because I saw so many men being... The Me Too movement was misused by these statements. It started with such a beautiful cause. It was such a beautiful the movement was so beautiful. Yes. They ruined it. They ruined it because tomorrow today I'll stand up and say, okay, this man did something to me. Years of reputation gone down the drain.
I agree.
Will anybody ask me once, did he or did he not? No, nobody asked any woman. The men were put in that pedestal that, okay, you have done something, you're a bad woman.
The frame is already fixed for men.
Yes. So are we shifting from the dirty patriarchy to this fake feminist? It is not healthy. So the thing should be to bring in the balance, not to create a competition between the two genders. It will never work. Then, of course, there will be a hike in divorce rates. That is what my job is, to make sure divorces aren't happening.
Hats off, ma'am. But I personally believe it might be any relationship, husband and wife, friendship, brother, sister. If there is mutual respect, lot many things can be solved within ourselves.
Trust and respect are the pillars
yes.
of love.
Yes.
Love of any kind.
Yes, true. And ma'am, how do you promote this equality? How do you follow to promote them?
How do I promote means?
Like you're working on gender equality. If you want to pass on a message to me, I don't know about it. Like I'm not following you. I don't know what cause you're working on.
It depends from person to person, firstly. If somebody is coming to me personally and what their situation is. So I don't have a generic statement for it. I go by per case that comes to me, firstly. Secondly, I run a group called Smilofies and Vidya on Facebook, and I keep doing a lot of videos and all. We have a YouTube channel also. So anybody who wants to listen to my talks and stuff, it is all over the internet. My footprints are there. So that is how I promote, and I also take up causes. Like presently, I've taken a cause of the domestic violence on Smilofies and Vidya also, where we have spoken about all three genders. And there is a case also that is running now, which I have put my hand in happily. I have filed a complaint against a socialite here in Bangalore called Sangeeta Gopal, who used the rape law against her vendors who came to ask for money. She threatened them by the rape law. So that is something that has not gone down too well with me. And if these laws, which were made to protect us, made for women to empower them, if it is being used by such women, the victims who actually need them will be looked down upon.
Yes.
The problem is we look at everybody in a very, very strange light because of women like these.
Yes.
So once taking punishment and going behind bar will send a very strong message to anybody trying the false case. If you go into the court today, 90% plus cases are false cases.
Yeah. Fake women taking advantage of men.
Yes. Yeah. And women who really need the laws don't go there.
Exactly.
They will not go because of bolte band mutthi laag ki kulri to khaak ki. So that mindset also we are working on. That hello, if you there is no Sita Sati, you have to become.
You were talking about women, you know, filing a false cases on men.
Yes, they're filing false cases on men, and men are going helter skelter because, of course, in the court of law, they are guilty until proven otherwise. But thankfully, they have got a little respite from the Supreme Court, where at least there is no arrest made now. They are still in a better position since last 1 year than what was happening before. Because the woman, the minute she goes and files a complaint, they used to, the entire family used to go behind bars. So that's way better. But there is no law standing with them. There is no strict law against fake cases. And my fight is here. And I want a very strict law against fake cases, if it is fake. Yes, every law can be used and misused. Even this law might be misused on real victims. But then that is what we are all there for, the NGOs. The NGOs will work towards it. And every NGO has lawyers with them. Every NGO knows the law in and out. They know the loopholes in and out. So I would request everybody to go to the court case only via NGOs and not go alone, because they will not know the law and the lawyers will take them for a ride. At the same time, both male NGOs and female NGOs are working closely. I'm working closely with both of them. I'm working very closely with the third gender also. So all genders, there should be laws protecting their basic rights to dignified life. And that is what my entire call is. Dignity. Okay.
Yeah, that's very sweet, ma'am. Even till today, till now, I was thinking about only women suffering, women facing all the issues. And I have got lot many information from you. And that was really nice and really wonderful. And ma'am, my next question is, what do you think the young people now, young generation, should get a change in themselves to be a better society tomorrow?
Young generation is pretty much more empowered than we think. Young generation will not have so many problems than our generation, because they have a precursor in us. We did not have anybody.
Yeah.
See, life has changed in front of us. Till 90s, our life was very different. With technology taking over, everything changed. Everything came on the palm top. The world is on the palm top. It has shrunk. So the young generation has not just got information, they have also got the insight and the knowledge and the intelligence to handle it way better than we could. So I think, and also we have been working around, a lot of schools and colleges have been working around imbibing these new values to the kids. The young generation is important. All they need to do is now sensitize each other. Sensitive towards the other genders also. So that is what is the job that we are doing. Sensitizing the generation next, so that they are not as bad as us.
Then, ma'am, do you think we are missing the same exposure what current generation is having when we were, you know, young or teenager?
Yes. Firstly, see, two, three things that have happened in our generation. We were made to the three things. Firstly, the education system, which was built in a very, we were made to dislike our own culture. Very important. Okay, so we were made to love the Western culture. So everything Western always attracted us. Anything, we never liked anything made in India. It was always, okay, what is there in the, oh, this is good. The cars also from everything. Western attracts us. Okay, first problem, that is it. Now, from there, then the culture started seeping in. Our culture, in particularly, if you see the roots, we are way too forward. If you see Khajuraho temple and all of that, we are way too forward, way too matured if we get back to our roots. So first angle is getting back to your roots, understanding where you come from. Second angle is the moral science that came.
True.
The moral science finished us because it did not teach us. If you pick up any religion, I somehow don't like religion. If you pick up any religion, be it any, they will tell you anger is bad. They will tell you fear is bad. Yes. Bad hai to nature deta nahi na. If nature has given you something, it has given you to protect yourself from threat. Anger and fear, they protect you. If you know how to understand them, if you make them your best friends, they are there to protect you. There's nothing to run away from. So from the
all
beginning,
we need is to.
From the beginning, we were taught not to. Angry only doesn't mean giving cuss words and killing people.
Yeah.
Angry also means a silent anger that we have within and we don't know how to express it.
Yes.
That is worst. The one giving cuss words is better because he's taken it out of the system. The one who's keeping it inside, it is becoming a silent volcano that will erupt in any form.
Exactly, exactly.
And that is the core reason why mental health issues are erupting today. Because we don't know how to express ourselves. So this is where we need to start beginning. The beginning is here. Understanding your emotions, understanding what is the need of every emotion in your life. From here, gradually, then you go up to the moral sciences. Rubbish, friend in need. If supposedly you are my friend and you come to me for some help, I might not be in the position to help you at that point of time. Now, if I'm unable to help you at that point of time, I am going through guilt also, right?
Yes.
It is not an easy thing for me to say no. We can't say no. We go into guilt. We go into everything. So proper communication is not there. Till the time you will not understand emotions, you will never be able to communicate well. If you will not be able to communicate well, you will lose every relationship around you.
Exactly.
Every relationship, if you see, the crux is emotions and communication. That's the crux.
Yes.
Crux. I don't like this one because this one speaks like this. I don't like that one because that one was rude to me. I don't like this because this one did this to me. By the end of the day, it is how you're speaking.
Exactly.
So all of this is what I am working with the next generation. That this is where your trust and respect comes in. If you know how to talk well, if you know how to express yourself without hurting the other one, automatically the respect and trust will increase. And the relationships will become stronger than ever.
True. Everybody has every emotion. The problem is we don't know where to put it appropriately. How to react, when to react.
We are not taught how to communicate.
Yeah.
Either people are screaming or silent. There's no in between. We are not taught how to. We are taught to run away from emotions. Every history, every religious book teaches you to run away from emotions. The Ten Commandments, which says even your sexual energy is considered as a crime. And that is so natural. How can it be a crime?
It can't be.
It's a crime. Please, I really need to understand all of this. These are all natural energies around us. What are we doing? So obviously mental health issues will come up. Because we are running away from ourselves.
Yes.
So once we are running away from our deep, strong emotions, the anger and fear are very strong emotions. If you don't give it an outlet, if you don't know how to give it a direction, they can ruin your lives.
True.
So with that, people are running helter-skelter today. So all the addictions are happening. Everything is happening because of that.
Yes. And many youngsters are falling into depression.
Not just youngsters. We are no less. Our age is no less. Youngsters are at least aware they are falling into depression. And depression again is a very loosely used term. Very loosely used term.
True.
Maybe we shall have that where I am. There is a different kind of a drug mafia going on there. Depression is again a different topic. Yes.
Ma'am, that was really lot many informations on emotions, lot many informations for, our generation and coming generation. And it was really exceptional knowing your point of view. And I have a few funny questions as well. You got to answer them. Okay. So, what is the first thing you grab as soon as you wake up in the morning?
Coffee.
A hot coffee. Yeah. Okay. Which is more preferable to you? Being nice to somebody or being fair?
Being fair.
And your biggest weakness?
People. And they have a strength also. Same. My weakness and my strength, my people.
Okay. What is that one thing you can't be without it?
Fake.
break.
Fake, fake. I can't be. I can't live without.
Okay.
Thing.
Nothing. Okay.
Nothing.
Which is
thing. Okay. I can live without everything.
Okay. So your favorite destination you would love to go again and again.
In India, Goa. Not Dubai. I love Dubai.
Okay. And what is that one thing you're missing which you had in your college days or school days? Okay. If you want to...
What I did then, I do it today also. So no, I'm not missing anything.
That's really nice, ma'am, because many women, I mean, even me, we leave out things behind after marriage, after kids, you know. We get to change according to the situations.
Emotional footages. So the child in me has never died. I never let it.
True. And define me as a teenager. If you were a teenager, define yourself.
Emotionally disturbed.
Mm-hmm.
Again, not knowing how to communicate. Hidden anger. Rebel.
Okay. So you have come to all those things and you're clear now. Yeah, and you're teaching people how to handle emotions.
Yes.
Very nice, ma'am. Very nice. It was truly, you know, wonderful talking to you. Thanks for your time and keep doing this work. And I must say, I have fallen in love with you. I've been following your Smilopai Zindagi from the time I have heard about it. And thank you, viewers. And thank you, Work TV, for giving me opportunity to talk to Miss Priya, such a wonderful personality. And yeah, keep watching Work TV, keep watching my show, Voice, and love you all. Love you.
Thank you, Archana. Bye. Thank you, Work TV. Thank you. Bye.